on the A414. That was just north of the A12 interchange. Broken down vehicle on the M5, that's being sorted out. It was southbound, junction 19 to 20, Portishead through to Clevedon, one lane closed, and Virgin Trains East Coast into and out of King's Cross to New...
Thank you very much, Lynn. So, Jack Whitehall is on the way in. That's the breaking news here, breaking guest news on The Breakfast Show. So after 9 o'clock, usually what happens is we get all our guests to ask each other questions. But because Jack has been a lazy guest, we should just all ask him questions, okay? So we're going to come up with a Jack Whitehall. He's in the chair.
Okay.
He's there for the taking, all right? So all come up with Jack Whitehall questions. That's Natalie and Brody and Rob Brydon and Belinda Carlisle. Belinda, you are qualifying or qualified as a yoga teacher?
Kundalini. So yoga, yeah.
You are qualified.
I haven't taken the final test, but yeah, I'm on my way, yeah.
Okay, so what does the final test entail?
It's a written test, actually.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it?
It's a written test. I've been doing it for Kundalini for about 20 years. Mm-hmm. I'm chanting out and coming out next year.
Nice.
Yeah, which is great. I've been studying mantras for a while. But yeah, written test, it's pretty intense.
Okay, this is all so I can just get around to my bus test today, that I'm taking my bus test.
You what?
My bus test.
What, to drive a bus?
Correct.
Why?
You're a genius, you're kind of genius.
Well, it'd be as satirical as you wish, but why on earth would you do that?
Because, stupidly, last year, she'll witness.
You had to ask, didn't you?
Stupidly, last year, we put an auction prize up for children in need. A veteran bus driven from London to Brighton by me. And then obviously it went for like 300 grand this trip.
Oh, gosh.
I know, good gosh is one phrase. And then so then they said, well, you obviously have to learn to drive a bus, and that's this week. But it's all written tests. This is the third written test this week. And I forgot my driving license, which is stupid.
Yeah.
Because that means you can't take the test. Which is why my wife is downstairs with the driver.
And how easy is it to drive those things?
I don't know. Do you know what? I've not yet sat behind the wheel.
But it's not all written, and then you pass that, and they say get in and have a go. Surely.
Actually, that is technically what happens.
What is madness?
I know. You're not allowed to get behind the wheel of the bus until you've committed, showed any some commitment by doing all the written tests, because otherwise everybody would just to get.
Oh,
in.
I see. All right, no, fair enough.
So when's this happening? We need to warn people to stay off the road.
Oh yes, November. There'll be national warnings, an international warning, no doubt. Right, Jack Whitehall on the way. More music from Natalie and Brulia, and now the news from Moira.
Researchers say the proportion of people living with dementia is levelling off in parts of Western Europe. The University of Cambridge study shows the number of elderly people with the condition in the UK has fallen, contrary to predictions that cases would soar. Professor Carol Brain from the Cambridge Institute of Public Health led the research. She says general improvements in health could explain the change.
In Western Europe, there have been dramatic changes in life expectancy, in our health, in all sorts of ways, including a reduction in heart attacks and strokes. So it does seem as though we may be seeing the playing out of better health across the life course and into older age in our brain health.
United Utilities have admitted they still can't put a timescale on when more than 300,000 households in Lancashire can stop boiling their water after more than 2 weeks. People in Blackpool, Preston and Chorley have been told not to drink tap water since a bug was found at a treatment works. Lynn Day has been forced to close her cafe.
We've been shut 2 weeks today and it's horrendous. Getting beyond a job now, it was only to be for a few days and now it's going into another week, I'm led to believe. I'm only a small cafe, I do not have the facilities to store boiled water. Health and safety kicks in, it's ridiculous.
The former Attorney General, Lord Morris of Aberavon, has said Parliament should step in to force the Chilcot inquiry into the Iraq War to publish its report. Lord Morris, who served in Tony Blair's first administration, has called the inquiry committee a disgrace. Greece is on course for its second general election this year after the Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras announced his resignation. During a televised address, he called on voters to give him a new mandate after the latest bailout deal with the country's European creditors divided his left-wing Syriza party. Vicky Price from the Centre for Economic and Business Research is an expert on Greece. She says Mr. Tsipras will probably win.
There is no one there as an alternative for leader, and he's likely to still form the largest party. He has proved to be the sort of leader who managed to survive, and he will ditch the very left-wing elements of his party during this election.
Police in Denmark are hunting for two thieves who stole a small bust by the French sculptor Auguste Rodin from a museum in Copenhagen in broad daylight. The theft happened last month, but police have just released CCTV footage of the robbery. Today's weather forecast, it'll be cloudy for many with drizzly rain in the west. Northern Ireland and northwest Scotland will have a breezy day with some showers, becoming brighter and warm in the southeast. BBC News at 4 minutes past nine, our next at 10 o'clock.
Thank you, Moira. Here's Vash for the sport now.
Thank you, Chris. Our weekly Friday morning look ahead, kind of celebration of the weekend of sport to come. And we begin at the World Athletics in Beijing with a certain sprinter who's apparently been working on his stuff.
My size was my issue. We have worked on that and everything is where it's supposed to be. I did my last start session yesterday. My coach was smiling, so thumbs up to me.
Yeah, thumbs up to Usain Bolt. By the time we chat again on Monday, we'll know if Bolt has successfully defended his 100 metres world title. Also, watch out this weekend for the heptathlon duel between Britain's Katarina Johnson-Thompson and Britain's Jessica Ennis-Hill. And at lunchtime tomorrow, Mo Farah runs in the 10,000 metres. Closer to home, Belgium to be exact, and back from its summer break is Formula One. Just a reminder, Lewis Hamilton is 21 points clear in the Drivers' Championship, with his Mercedes team miles ahead in the Constructors.
Naturally, we're here to win, and we're focused on making sure that we stay up front, but we're fully aware that other teams are pushing very hard and Ferrari looking great, so we don't arrive at any race thinking that we are superior to anyone.
Rugby Union World Cup warm-up matches this weekend include France, England and Italy, Scotland, who've lost six in a row, but for whom apparently the result doesn't matter. Here's coach Vern Cotter.
We're focusing on the content of our rugby. If we can look after that and get in a good performance and do things well, the simple things well, and then it looks after itself. Everyone's aware of results, but added pressure on the team will only stop it performing.
Also this weekend, let's rush through this, the final Ashes test. Australia resumed today 2-8-7 for three. Football, of course, men's and women's. Tennis, Andy Murray in Cincinnati and through to the semi-finals. There's Rugby League Super 8s, Euro Hockey in London, Euro Modern Pentathlon in Bath, Triathlon in Stockholm, and also in Sweden for the Women's Road World Cup Cycling.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Nice preview there, Bass.
Online, on digital radio, and on 88-91 FM. BBC Radio 2.
The next. How about a bit of weekend ELO for us? Mm-hmm. very bad. Very, very naughty. Naughty, naughty, naughty. Jack Whitehall has arrived, ladies and gentlemen. Shall we boom into the studio? Come on now. Go and sit over there. Don't hug him, Natalie. He's been naughty.
Sorry.
No, no,
it is everything to
put
me.
All those apples away, we don't care. We don't want your apples. So stand in the corner with your fingers on your lips until home time.
Can I sit?
I think you need to. All right, Jack, welcome to the programme. I don't mind at all that you're late. I think it's really fine.
Everyone kept saying it's fine. This is Chris Evans.
You sound terrible. No, I don't. You sound like Barry White with laryngitis.
Does my voice sound that bad?
Yes.
Oh, it does, yeah. Wow. Now I'm hearing it for the first time.
But everyone last night gave me his finest
business. Don't block the liver out with your body. You're really not here, are you? You are so not here. So what did they say, sorry?
They kept me, well, it's fine, it's Chris Evans.
You won't
just go all the way through. But I didn't, I went home very early.
About a minute ago.
I had a Jägerbomb with Chris Akabusi and my dad.
Did you?
And
that was sentence again, that's priceless. That
Chris Akabusi was there and he had a Jägerbomb with my dad, and that's when I realised it was time to go home. So then I did go home. I have been home. But everyone was like, it's fine, Chris Evans will.
We know it's been home because our taxi was waiting outside at licensed fee payers' expense for about 3 days. It doesn't matter. I think it's really cool. You had a premiere of your movie. It's fine. The Bad Education movie. You might as well tell us about it if you can still speak.
I can't really remember it. I saw it last night and
you were in it, you made it.
People were really nice about it, but I'm not very good at dealing with praise, so that's maybe why this has happened.
Right.
But it was very good fun. And Chris Akabusi came, he laughed. He's a great person to have at a premiere. I learned that. I can't really sell the film though.
All right, don't worry about that. The film will sell itself. Okay, all our guests have got questions for you. Belinda, you go. This is Belinda Carlisle, by the way.
Nice to meet you. What was the worst question you were asked last night?
The worst question I was asked last night? There's quite a lot of nudity in the film, and my mum and dad saw it for the first time, and they weren't very happy. So,
really?
The hardest thing was sort of fielding that and fielding their expectations. But I feel like I might have let them down somewhat. My father, especially.
Really?
His summation of the film is, "Well, this wasn't very subtle, was it?" Which I don't know whether I'm going to stick on the poster.
All right.
It wasn't a ringing endorsement.
Question now from Natalie and Brutley to Jack Whitehall.
Okay, this isn't about the film.
I invited you to the after party, she wasn't.
Because I was going to bed early.
Responsibly.
Because of Chris's show.
Thank you, Natalie. You're welcome back anytime. Jack, make the most of it.
Mine's not about the film, but have you given the thumbs up yet to your lovely girlfriend Gemma to get a puppy dog?
Oh, no, this is a wee baby dog sat for Natalie. And she loved the dog, but no, she's not having a dog.
Okay.
Settle out. Is that hard?
He's going into the mode of
definitely.
Would
you look after it if we went away?
He's talking to me now, listeners. No.
No.
Of course not. My friend's in your film.
Which friend?
Which film? Steve Spears.
Steve Spears.
Steve Spears.
Yeah, Steve Spears.
You know him if you saw him. You'd recognise him.
I'd like to try and involve the listeners in this.
Oh, sorry. All right. Okay. Who was the best guest other than Chris Akabusi? Who did you see turning up last night? And you went, if it's possible and it could be somebody more stellar than Chris Akabusi, who did you see across the room and go, oh my word, they've come to my premiere?
You're going to like this.
Go on.
Nigel Havers.
Okay, let's do traffic and travel.
Yeah,
exactly.
He's
really good.
You got Matthew Arne, the Brave Mind Stride.
Target demographic.
I love Nigel Havers. He's a charming man.
Actually, we were playing this game earlier on about Radio 2 presenters and who we'd like to play them in movies of the month. And for Jeremy Vine, Nigel Havers was number 3.
Oh, yeah, I could see him pulling that off. Who would play you?
I want Damian Lewis to play me.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
Is that shooting too high?
I think that's good.
Okay, who would you like to play you?
I think maybe Chris Akabusi. No, seriously, he did an episode of Last of the Summer Wine where he played
the old man. I would love Chris Akabusi texting and saying, I wasn't even at the premiere last night. Jack just wants
man
me to be.
Him to be Chris Akabusi.
Okay, I'll ask you what.
He wears Alan Partridge blazers as well, with crests.
He doesn't think he does, though.
But he's the best person ever.
All right, okay, good.
His daughter's called Shakira Akabusi.
Good, well done. There'll be more Chris Akabusi information following the next live track from Natalie and Brilli. What are you going to play for us next, Natalie?
Wrong impression.
Okay, wrong impression. If you can get through, here we go, Natalie and Brilli. These guys, they're all brilliant. Belinda Carlisle's here, Jack Whitehall. He's sort of here, isn't he?
He's turned up. he's a husk of a man, let's be honest.
So,
Jack, husky voice.
Let me ask you about this. Yesterday I saw you on TV, I spied you on BBC Breakfast News. You were dishing out real GCSE results to the students, weren't you?
Yeah.
And that sounds like a bit of fun, but in the middle of it you thought, oh my goodness me, this is a really big deal. It's just hit me now.
And they weren't meant to do it live on air. They said that I'd be there and I'd give them their results, then they cut away and then the people would open their results and then it would come back to them. But then the lady made the guy open his results live on television,
a presenter. Really?
Yeah, it was it was like crisis aversion. It was nearly the most car crash television you've ever seen. Thankfully, this guy passed his exams. But, like, I mean, he would have had a meltdown had he failed. I'm not sure whether it was a wise idea.
That's not good.
No, it's not good at all. I mean, you know, we've sort of dabbled with that in the radio in the past, and we've done it on this show actually. And after we did it once, we said we're never doing that again. It's not worth it.
They said, well, we don't want to go to a straight A school. We want to go to somewhere that's, you know, there's been struggling.
Maybe shake it up a bit.
To the straight A school. Okay, we'll go to the place where, you know,
because we've now
crushed within the envelope.
We've now sort of touched on your heartstrings here. We're now sort of bringing you back in, aren't we, now? Because this is important. So are you a bit with us now, Jack?
I'm a little bit with you.
Hey, Jack is back! Okay, tell us about your movie.
It's all this stuff here he had before we even started playing.
It was the music that influenced the King.
Each one of them would have a story behind them, guaranteed.
The tracks that shaped one of the world's greatest performers.
Boy, you can hear everything that Elvis did and everything that he wanted to do was kind of represented among these records.
He liked all kinds of music. You go through the records and you'll find it different.
The rhythm and blues Elvis, the pop vocalist, the dramatic Mario Lanza voice. You can hear it all in there.
Elvis's Suitcase of 78s.
Hi, I'm Chris Isaac. I'm here in Nashville with Scotty Moore. We got Elvis's Suitcase full of 78s.
Wednesday night from 10 on BBC Radio 2.
Actually, we have a push though. Why the heck not? Abdul's back. Good morning, Abdul. Good
morning, Chris. How are you?
Good. From your travels around the world, how's your summer been?
It's been busy. It's been a lot of crisscrossing oceans and seeing family, and it's been great though.
Good for you. That's Natalie Imbruglia over there. She's an internationally renowned actress and superstar.
I think I've heard of her
from the music world. This is Rob Brydon, who's just one of the most reliable men in show business. This is Belinda Carlisle, who has 28 song CD set here, which
is fantastic. I've been a fan since I was in grade 6.
Okay, and then this guy here is the naughty boy. It's Jack Whitehall.
It's written all over his face.
He's very naughty.
Rob Brydon.
Now, Abdul, you have a great way with children. What's the best way that we should castrate him? Sorry, chastise him.
Love. I think love solves everything. A little bit of love.
Too much love.
A little bit of understanding.
Too much love you've had in your life.
There's no.
That's your problem.
I blame you.
What?
I was brought up on Chris Evans.
Yeah.
And this is what happens if you're brought up on Chris Evans.
That was the old Chris Evans.
You're the reason that there's a darkness inside.
Okay. I can't believe you're blaming this on me. But it's sort of working.
Timing is bad.
You're reaping what you sow, Chris. I think that's what we're doing.
Because I'm unhappy.
Pray so.
And I'm unhappy because of you.
Okay, that's that famous line in the film Arthur, isn't it? Not all of us drink because we're poets. Some of us drink because we're not poets. Abdul, can you please lift the mood?
Immediately. Chris, I sometimes wonder when I started losing my sense of imagination, that marvelous ability to conjure up tall tales came naturally to us when we were kids. Nowadays, I find it hard to summon anything more exciting than the next item on my to-do list. My son, on the other hand, is in full fantasy flow, much like Jack, maybe. He makes up worlds in his mind, remixes stories in his head, and then heroically acts them out. The other day, he told me that he was soon going to transform into a superhero and leap off a building so he could fly to some dangerous place to help put out fires and save lives. Being an anxious dad, any talk of jumping off buildings gets me queasy. So I explained that superheroes were make-believe and that he mustn't go soaring off anytime soon. Silly Abba, he rolled his eyes. Don't you know? It's all in my imagination. I'm sure some of the celebs on Rob's show, Would I Lie to You, wish that their embarrassing escapades were the stuff of fantasy too. I think we like the show so much, other than it's very funny, of course, because we find it refreshing to see famous people appear vulnerable. In a time when we curate our online profiles like their works of art and insta-snap how fabulous our lives are, we are also constantly bemoaning the lack of authenticity. In this world we're just beginning to understand the miracle of living, sang the wonderful Belinda Carlisle. I think as I get older, I appreciate this a little more. To set aside pretense and embrace the messiness of life and love isn't easy. Say, the Quran encourages us, O my Lord, cause me to enter into all I do with truth, and cause me to leave it in truth, and grant me out of your grace a strength that sustains me. Sometimes truth is found in myth, epic, and allegory. Sometimes truth is found in children's play, in the imagination, as my son would say. It is the quest for truth that is constant, to be honest with ourselves and others, and search for all that is good and beautiful. We need all the help we can get. I, for one, will start by learning from my son, a real superhero.
Oh, you were touched in at the end there, weren't you? You nearly went at the end.
I did.
Okay, I nearly went for you. Well done, my friend. Breathe. But can you stand out of the way, because Lynn's next. Thanks very much. Lynn with the tour microphone.
Thank you. Aberdeen to Dundee Road. The A90 is still closed in both directions for accident investigation work near Strathcathro. Looks like that's going to go on for the rest of the day. M6, if you're travelling south, very heavy into Birmingham. This is from around about Junction 10 near the M54. And of course, you can't leave northbound the M6 at Junction 12. It's closed for traffic management for V Festival. M50, one lane out. This is eastbound, Junction 2 to 1, Ledbury through to Tewkesbury. There's a breakdown your way. M25, three lanes closed anti-clockwise. Got an accident at Junction 22, St Albans, and queuing traffic on the M4. This is eastbound towards London. Junction 6 to 5, that's Slough through to Langley. There was an accident there. It's been cleared, but it's also slow going the other way westbound, so a couple of miles of queuing traffic there as well. I'm back for more in 25 minutes.
All right, thank you so much, Lynn. Special guest this morning, not to mention yet, it's Michael Moore. Good morning, Michael. Come over here, come and say hello. Now, Michael's given loads of pleasure. You're going to be here with his guest this morning. His special guests are James Pietrzak, Carly Giles, and Hayley McGann. Would you like to say hello to the guys, Michael?
Hello to everyone, and thank you for your hospitality. And thank you for Carly and Hayley for all they do for James.
All right, pal. Listen, thanks so much for your donation to Children Need.
Thank you.
Okay, and we'll see you at something soon.
You will.
Okay, all right.
That's a definite. Okay.
They've all been fabulous, actually, in the end. They've all been fabulous. First of all, can you read that out, Jack, about what Rob Brydon has to offer the world?
Rob has a play called Future Conditional at the Old Vic in London. Previews start on September the 1st, and it opens on September the 10th.
Thank you very much indeed. Belinda Carlisle's been here. Rob, what does she have to offer?
Belinda Carlisle, the CD singles 1986 to 2014, is out today.
Perfect. Natalie Imbruglia's been here working.